He's not going to admit he was lying, obviously.
I'm not lying. It's because they wouldn't admit I was lying if I'm not lying.
Would you like to admit you were wrong?
No.
So you are a liar.
Wait till the video that I bring out that shows exactly why I wasn't wrong. You know, you can wait for the video about how wrong you were about everything that you said. If you want to keep waffling about nonsense that you don't understand, and neither does anybody else here, that's fine. You are going on about relativity, which you don't understand, and no one here understands. I haven't studied relativity. I don't know a lot about relativity. So I don't really understand the arguments.
I actually do understand it.
No,
that's what's funny,
the thing,
right?
You really don't understand it in the slightest way. So you think you understand it, but every single thing that you say is actually
fundamentally
wrong.
Based on the very small bit of research I've done.
Clearly see that they are wrong, and neither of us really know what we're talking about.
How do you know me and you're in land about? Okay, so the fact that you don't understand it has no bearing on the fact that I actually have researched it and read what Einstein said.
Yeah, but
and
you
that
still
you
don't understand
it.
You don't understand
it. You don't know that.
You
how do you know
you
if I have an inaccurate
really
understanding
don't.
If you don't understand it?
I'm saying that you're not right, but I don't have the full answers to explain why right now.
Oh, so you know I'm wrong, but you don't know why.
No, I know you're wrong. I just don't have the ability to succinctly answer why right now. What I'm saying is that your conclusion and the way you've reached your conclusion is wrong. And I'm going to find the words and the way to succinctly explain why. I have professors from Edinburgh University telling me you are wrong. There's no point sitting here with you going around in circles about relativity when neither of us have the proper knowledge to make this discussion work. Right?
I know 100 times more about this than you. And you want to keep bundling me in with your ignorance.
Neither of us have enough knowledge for this conversation, and that
just
is a
keep
fact.
Saying it.
I will come back to this when both of us have enough knowledge for the conversation. Right now, neither of us do. Simple as that.
How can you understand relativity if you can't even understand the difference between rotation and orbit?
Dude. Orbit is a rotation.
No.
No. Rotate is to spin, turn, or revolve.
Which you clearly just had the difference explained to you.
Right. Mickelson-Morley was not set up.
You have a
problem. Right.
Mickelson-Morley,
they take it too literal. They can't just have any sort of thought process for themselves to just understand that that's exactly what you fucking
mean. Yeah, they had to
well,
take that pedantically.
The orbit is rotation, right? Like, he just wrote the definition.
Not.
Okay, well, look. Hey, Connell,
okay,
since you're so smart, can you answer my question?
Okay,
does the Earth revolve around the sun, yes or no?
Yes.
Rotate is to spin, turn, or revolve. Earth does not rotate around the sun. It orbits or revolves. A rotation is not a revolution. Rotate is to spin, turn, or revolve. Which is right when he says the Earth revolves around the sun. He's wrong when it says it rotates around the sun. There's a difference between
so when I cite NASA saying the Earth rotates around the sun, you'll all admit you're wrong, or are you going to say NASA's wrong?
Well, NASA would be using the wrong word in that case.
You just read the definition that the Earth revolves around the sun, and then you read the definition of rotate and it says revolves in the definition that you read.
No, okay? Rotate is to spin, turn, or revolve. Maybe you haven't heard me properly because you can't rotate around another body.
Why does your definition of rotation that even you read off have the word revolve in it?
It didn't.
Read again then.
Rotate is to spin, turn,
or revolve.
Right? That rotate, revolve, different things there, okay?
You just said rotate is to spin, turn, or revolve. We use the words differently so that it's not confusing.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
Shut
so that we're not confused.
Dude, I swear to you, you actually need to get in a boxing ring or something.
Shut
because
the fuck
you
up
think
and just
you can disrespect.
I'm trying to move the conversation
so
forward. Can we all just agree? Can we all just agree?
Teddy bear.
Can we all just agree?
You're like a giant teddy bear.
Again, can we all just agree very simply to say the Earth rotates around its axis but revolves around the sun? If we agree that, we can just move forward.
You're still trying to interrupt me again.
Okay. If we agree that, we can move forward. Can we agree that yes or no?
This is insane.
So right.
The point
Whitsett,
is
I am trying to move the conversation forward.
Correct.
Can we agree that yes or no?
Or convenient?
Can we agree that yes
the
or no?
Revolves around the sun.
Shut up! Let Austin respond for fuck's sake.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
We say orbit or revolution to distinguish between the axial rotation of the Earth and the Earth moving around the sun. Now, as it pertains to what we're talking about, MC Toon's home run was that, oh, well, you don't have any measurement of stationariness. I said, you don't measure stationary. That's stupid. It's a very stupid thing to say. So then he keeps saying it. So I said, okay, well, then what would be a measurement of stationariness? He said,
measure for rotation, and if you get none, then it's stationary.
He said, a negative result is not proof of stationariness. It's not evidence of stationariness. Negative results would be evidence for a stationary.
No, Earth. It's not. In fact, it's quite the opposite. It's a nothing result.
So then I said, how would you measure stationariness then? And he says,
You create a device that's designed to measure rotation. If it comes up with zero rotation, you've measured stationariness.
Which would, of course, be a negative result, directly contradicting his claim that negative results aren't actual evidence of stationariness, because he has to double speak. And once I called him out on that, you guys jumped in and brought up the semantical difference in orbit and rotation. Thanks for playing.
So, here's the thing. You might lose a debate about relativity, but that in no way debunks the fact that the Earth is a globe.
Prior to holding a justified belief, one must fully understand what that belief is that they're going to internalize and accept. And they actually don't know. And he just now openly admitted he doesn't know. But you'll see his arrogance and ego come out in the second side of his mouth, where he then says, no, you're an idiot. You don't understand anything about relativity. You're wrong. I'm going to make a video about how you're so wrong. And then you're like, wait, what am I wrong about? Oh, I don't understand anything about relativity.
I've actually had people that support him reach out and say, like, please don't debate him anymore because he can't prevent himself from getting way too worked up and it's too dangerous. Literally.
I'm an angry person. I struggle to control my temper, my anxiety, my stress levels. Very much so. Very much like Bruce Banner.
I am always angry.
So that's the funniest part. I was like, I'm trying to be nice to him.
I know he had a heart problem the last time y'all tried to debate. Are you telling me right now, like, hang on, is Robot Polisher down there? Are you recording this, buddy? Are you telling me that people who know him have reached out to you and told you that it's like a danger to his life if he debates you because
yes.
He gets too worried? Wow. That's incredible.
Yeah.
You'd think he would be a little bit more humble in his approach. Like you might die from trying to debate flat earthers. You think you might take it down a notch.
Oh, so you're acting like a child.
Yeah.